Ronald McDonald House makes it possible for families to go through some really difficult times and come out okay at the end of it. And we owe a great debt to all the work that everybody in this organization does, because helping families stay together during those really difficult emotional times is probably one of the most important parts of healthcare. Instead of just being able to serve 13 families, Ronald McDonald House is now going to be able to serve, or soon going to be able to serve 73 families. And that's a big increase. It means a lot more young people, a lot more kids who have all the support that they need to heal.
There's a lot of other kids going through similar things. And some of these kids that I've met there are now my closest friends. And we can really empathize with each other, and we can really, like, we're going through the same thing, so we know the same language. There's other people that about my age that I can experience this with, even if it's not the funnest thing to experience. And I think it should always be remembered that it's not just Ronald McDonald House, it's Ronald McDonald Home.
As chair of the Capital Campaign, I can honestly say that the people of British Columbia owe an immense debt of gratitude for the government of BC stepping forward and giving the support to this project here. Because without it, we would not be here today, and this vision of this fantastic new home to serve the people of BC would just be still a dream. But because of you and your leadership, thank you.
I just also want to say thank you at this moment to all the volunteers and donors who make that kind of support possible at Ronald McDonald House. And I want to say hooray, because there's too many families who don't get the benefit of the house, and this is a great day to know that there's going to be that many more who do. So thank you very much.